गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल अगेन स्टार्ट विद आर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विद द रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1, दैट इज एवोल्यूशन एंड फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ बिजनेस. इन दिस चैप्टर फर्स्ट विल गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ ह्यूमन एक्टिविटी. नाउ ह्यूमन एक्टिविटी मीन्स दोज एक्टिविटीज विच आर अंडरटेकन बाई ह्यूमन बींग्स टू फुलफिल देयर बेसिक नेसेसिटीज. दीज आर ऑफ टू काइंड्स, इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी and non-economic activity. Now, first, economic activities are those activities which are undertaken with the motive to earn money or profit. Example, a salon, a general store, these all are being running with the motive to earn profit. Coming to the second part of human activity, that is non-economic activity, these are those kind of activities which are undertaken out of love, affection, care and sympathy. Okay, these are not done with the purpose of earning money or profit, yet it gives psychological and mental satisfaction. Example, mother preparing food for her child, a person contributing a portion of profit for community development or for the orphanages. Okay, this will all be coming under the non-economic activity. Again reminding you, non-economic activity provides psychological satisfaction to human beings, whereas economic activity provides physiological or monetary satisfaction to the human beings. Now, economic activities can broadly be classified into three categories, that is business, employment and profession. Okay, now if any person is running any sort of activity for the purpose of earning money or profit, it can either be business, profession and employment. We're going to understand the meaning of all these three terms. First one is business. Now, business is an economic activity which involves production or procurement of goods and services for the purpose of selling them to the consumers on a regular basis with the motive to earn profit. So, four things are essential in definition of business. It requires either production or procurement. When we are talking about production, it means converting raw material into the finished goods. When we are talking about procurement, it means buying from someone and reselling it to the consumers. So in business, either we are producing or procuring goods for exchanging with the consumers with the motive to earn profit, and it must be done on a regular basis. Coming to the next one, that is employment. Now, employment is such a contractual relationship which involves two partners, or we can say which involves two parties, that is employer and employee. Employer is that person who provides salary or wages, and employee is a person who renders his services in lieu of salary or wages. So, there is a contractual relationship between employer and employee. Coming to the next one, that is profession. It is an economic activity which requires special knowledge and training, and this person is using such knowledge to serve different sections of society. Example, CA. A person is specialized in accountancy and rendering his services for maintaining accounts of the society. Example, a doctor. Doctor is having a specialized knowledge of medical field and utilizing that knowledge in treating the patients. Okay, so profession, examples of profession can be chartered accountant, doctors, lawyers, a teacher. Fine, now we are coming to that of features of business. Features can also be called as characteristics of business. The very first feature of business is economic activity. We know that business is an economic activity because it is being done with the motive to earn profit. Every businessman runs his or her own business with the motive to earn profit. That is why business is an economic activity. Coming to the second one, production or procurement of goods and services. Now, either in business, a person is producing the goods or services or buying it from the third party in order to resell it to the consumers. So business involves either production or procurement of goods and services. Coming to the third one, sale or exchange. business involves selling of goods and services between the buyers and the sellers. That means business is selling goods to the final consumers. Coming to the fourth one, regularity in dealing. If a person is exchanging a pen with a friend for rupees 10, it will not be considered as a business because it is doing for only one time. But what is happening when a person is doing such sort of transactions on a regular basis, then only that particular activity will be called as a business. Coming to the fifth one, that is profit motive. Each and every businessman runs his business with the motive to earn money or profit. A business cannot be imagined without earning a profit. Nobody will going to run their business in market without the purpose of earning profit. So profit earning is the main motive of business. And the last and very important characteristics of business is investment of capital. Capital is the basic necessity of business, or we can say that finance is the lifeblood of business. Business requires capital to be invested in. To just start with, we require capital at the time of starting the business also, during the business also. So investment of capital is the basic necessity to run a business. We cannot imagine business without injecting capital into that. So here we have completed with all the six features of business. That is, it is an economic activity. It involves production or procurement of goods and services. Third one, it involves selling or exchange of goods and services between the buyers and the sellers. It involves regularity in dealing. Transactions doing on one-time basis will not be considered as a business. Fifth one, it is being undertaken with the motive to earn profit. And the last one is capital is required to run a business. Here we have completed with all the characteristics and today's topic. Tomorrow we're going to take another topic of business studies.